I know. You tune in on a Friday night, you expect to see the two best-looking guys on TV. Rod Lindsay and, yeah, Carl Anthony. But we're actually a hologram. We're not really here. If I poked Carl in the head, my hand would go right through. Want to see it? Nah. So what you are going to see tonight, however, is Cosmo's Corner, which has expanded his real estate. It's Mr. Cosmo's neighborhood now, apparently, because he's going to take over the whole show. And he is going to show you some up-and-coming, rising filmmakers that are they're going to make a splash. And he was lucky enough to get a chance to talk to them before they're too big to talk to us. So, stay tuned for more In My Opinion, where, after all, it is the only one that truly counts.
Hey, everybody, what's up? This is Cosmo welcoming you to Cosmo's Corner right here on In My Opinion, regular installment every week. You know where we are right here, letting you know what's happening with all the hot stuff and the not-so-hot stuff in the film industry, all the newest releases, and we're on a special assignment here right at the Independent Black Film Festival. That's right, I'm making a lot of new friends, networking with all the hottest new cinematographers, producers, directors, screenwriters, what have you. So stay tuned, and we're going to give you all the exclusives later. Hey, everybody, you know what it's all about right here at Cosmo's Corner every week on In My Opinion. Once again, I got so many friends in the film industry, I don't know what to do, man. I mean, it's just, you know, man, when you're this popular, you know, but you got to show love to everybody. So, you know, I have my good friend here, Orlando Jones, flew in just to interview a brother, hang out with me. So I want to find out everything that's happening with you, man. What's been going on? I know you got a lot going on.
Man, I'm trying to pay these bills, keep my mama in the style that she'd become accustomed to. That's the first thing we do.
Moms, you hear that, right?
Yeah,
for working sure. For you, Mom.
Yeah, she's shopping right now. She ain't watching no TV, trust me. But what am I doing? I'm starting a one-hour drama for ABC called Evidence.
Nice.
With John Wells, who produced ER and West Wing, so we're doing
wow.
that.
Wow, okay.
That's what I'm shooting right now, so we're just going for San Francisco. We're doing that. And obviously, Independent Black Film Festival, down here to represent that in ATL.
Absolutely. Now, the last time I saw you, you were in Atlanta.
Yeah.
You were on the screen. Mm-hmm. You just done Drumline.
Oh yeah, okay.
So how is it working in the Atlanta industry? What is the difference between working and doing a production in Atlanta and mm-hmm. doing a piece in LA?
Oh, you know, Atlanta's got that down home feel, you know what I mean?
Right.
And I'm from the South, so you know, I get to see, you know, my people, you know, which is always lovely. And you know, in ATL, it's just a different vibe, you know. In Hollywood, your car break down on the side of the road, people drive by and honk at you like you're crazy. In Atlanta, people pull over and go, "Baby, you look like my son. Let me ask you something. You need a ride somewhere?"
Welcome to Atlantis.
So for real. So I mean, it's just that energy is something that, you know, when you grew up in it and you go right. away somewhere else, you know, you just kind of you miss it. You know what I mean? So
exactly.
Shooting in Atlanta was dope. You know, obviously my friend Dallas Austin is here. And, you know, it's just lovely to be back against the folks, man, so.
Wow. So tell me about that relationship with Dallas. Dallas is making a segue. We all know that Dallas mm-hmm. is one of the biggest music producers in U.S. history.
Mm-hmm.
So now he's making a shift into film. How's mm-hmm. that working out, in your opinion?
Well, I mean, obviously,
pretty well, I'm sure.
Based on his life, so, I mean, it's going pretty good. I think it's going well for him. I mean, obviously, I'm biased. You know, he's one of my best friends, and I'm a fan. But I think primarily what he's trying to do is let people know in the Atlanta area and also just in the South that you don't need to necessarily go to Hollywood to be a success. You can create content here, and you can actually be a success here.
Wait, what did you say?
You can create content here. Here first.
You don't need to go to Hollywood.
You really don't. Well, there's no reason to. You got a camera right there last night. That's camera, right? Yeah, that's camera. And this microphone right here, we got me and you. What are we doing? We're creating content. So to me, you don't need to go to Hollywood to be on Access Hollywood in order for it to be valid. This is valid. This is just as good as what they do. So as far as I'm concerned, I think when people think about Hollywood and going to New York and all these different places, they forget that, you know, Outkast started here. Didn't nobody go find them off in New York?
Right here in Atlantis, folks.
So, I mean, I think that's what people often forget, particularly minorities we forget, because we always think we need the mainstream press in order to make our mark. But all the mainstream press essentially does is take the things we do and then parlay it. So we
after
just start parlaying
fact.
Ourselves. That's an SAT word right there, parlay.
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 Yeah. With that.
See, because I scored 800 on my SAT.
Oh, yeah, 800?
For both sections.
Both sections? My man, that's hot.
Ladies and gentlemen, In My Opinion, Cosmo's Corner, you know we're always bringing it to you hot. I'm bringing it to you as hot as I can bring it. Got my man Orlando Jones here, so you know you need to stay tuned because we're always going to let you know that In My Opinion is the only opinion that matters.
True.
Stay tuned. Hey, what's up? Welcome back to Cosmo's Corner, and this is Cosmo, the king of the corner. That's right. I'm trying to let you all know what's happening. I'm trying to let you all know. All my good friends here who have come out to spend time with me, the dear Miss Tamela Jones.
That's
right.
How you doing?
I so appreciate you taking time out of your busy schedule just to come see me, right?
Just to come and see you.
Yeah. So what's been going on with you?
A lot of stuff. You know, I am getting into producing and writing, and that's why I'm here, to see what you guys are doing down here.
So you're trying to change the game.
Got to, because you know all the brothers are writing, so now it's time for the sisters to kick in, because we are talented and we are smart.
Sisters, you hear that?
Enough to write and get into production. So I'm here to check out what you guys got going on, see the work that's done, as you know, an example, and possibly get involved in some things just so I can see how the independent black film circuit is done.
Right. So everybody knows you for a lot of your on-camera work, but if you could just give us a brief rundown of your resume and stuff like that.
Oh my God, I'm just gonna give you a little bit.
I mean, I know it's quite long, but if you could just encapsulate it for us, you know.
Okay, well, the first movie I did was Booty Call.
Oh yes.
Very first movie I did, and we'll skip a couple of years, and we'll go to Two Could Play That Game. Next Friday, The Brothers. And the latest I'll give you is Head of State with Chris Rock.
Ah, yes, Head of State. Indeed, indeed. So what is it like in the film industry for a sister? You know, of course, we see one thing on the screens, but, you know, it's a totally different ballgame behind
It's hard.
Really?
It's a hard thing because they are... This business is really suited for the Caucasian ethnic background.
Come on, now wait a minute. Where are you getting that from?
Formulated for that. I'm not saying that they're prejudiced and they don't let us in, but it is formulated.
You know,
for that.
I get so tired of people saying stuff like this. Just because they own all the movie houses, just because they own the production companies, just because they wouldn't let any of us in their productions back in the day, that doesn't mean anything. I mean, come on.
Of course it doesn't mean anything. So that's why when we are accepted to do a couple of things, it is very smart and intelligent of us to create from what we've taken.
So Tamela, next thing you know, I guess you're gonna tell me now that they're trying to manipulate our image in the film industry and by typecasting us and creating stereotypes.
Well, the only thing that they have always allowed us to do since before I was even thought of is comedy.
Oh,
comedy,
yes.
Comedy.
I just thought that that was because we were naturally funny though.
Yeah. We are.
I mean, come on. We know they really wouldn't do that now, would they?
Would they? So it was very important that I would say Denzel won for Training Day. Very important that Sidney Poitier won. It's very important that Halle Berry won. Very important that Jamie just won for the Ray Charles story. Very important that Don Cheadle and Morgan Freeman were nominated and also won. Congratulations to Morgan Freeman. That opens up a lot of doors for us. But with that, we have to take that as a door opener ourselves, even the ones that are underneath them and in status, I would say, and start creating and looking at what they're being accepted for, the dramatic parts, and, you know, take from there. You know, there's a lot of people out there that are doing their own thing. I know Lorenz Tate and his brothers have opened up a production company. And then you have Orlando Jones, who is aspiring with Dallas Austin, who's also from Atlanta, Georgia. And people are starting to catch on and do the things that they need to do in order to have a set place for us in this business. And, you know, once we, I believe, get enough power, we can, regardless if they're willing to accept it or not, open up our own film studio.
Yes.
That's the goal
that sounds like a plan.
Is important. And it's not just saying that when we do that, we're only going to hire black people to come in and do it. It belongs to us. And that is a place where we can exercise our talents the way we see they should be seen.
Right. See, you won't see any Jim Crowism here, you know what I mean? We're just looking for the best people to work. And of course, I want to congratulate you in advance on your Academy Award. That will be coming someday.
Thank you. I love you because you love me and I love you. That's my Diana Ross right there.
No, everybody.
But soon, you know, I just have to keep working very hard and never give up. And in this business, like I was telling you, this right here, and I won't say it out loud, we hear a lot of no and a lot of doors closing. And you can't let that discourage you and you can't give up. You always have to push forward and give your best in whatever it is. And if you're not satisfied with what's being handed to you, create your own. And that is an important message. I'm trying to get out there to all the young people, as I still will go and audition and do those films for those studios. I still will create my own stuff, you know?
And you heard it right here, live and in person, Miss Tamela Jones urging you to kick that door down.
Kick it down.
This has been another fine edition of Cosmo's Corner. Stay tuned.